Hey, what's going on everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to be teaching you guys about check buttons in Python. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. Okay, everybody. So let's create a check button, but first we'll need a window. Window equals TK. And then we're going to follow this with window dot main loop. Now we'll need to create a check button to add to the window. So I think I'm going to rename this as checkbox because I think that sounds better. It's also shorter too. So checkbox equals check button. We're going to be adding this check button to our window. We can set some text with text equals. Maybe I'll place Python here. We can also associate a variable with our check button. Variable equals, and then we'll need to create a variable. So I'm going to do this after we create our instance of our window. Let's create a variable just called x. X equals int var. So this is going to store an integer within x. We're going to set the variable of check button to equal x, or whatever else you named this basically. So with this x variable, we can assign x a value depending if the check button is checked or unchecked. And we do this with onvalue and offvalue. Onvalue equals, let's say 1. If we check our check button, x is going to equal the onvalue, which we'll just set to 1. And then offvalue is what x will equal if it's unchecked. And we'll set this to 0. Then we can also associate a command with check button. So command equals, and let's create a function called display. And we'll do that at the top. Def display. We'll just print a message. Print I like Python. And then we'll need to add this checkbox. So we can do that easily with pack. Checkbox.pack. And let's give it a go. Here's our checkbox. It says Python. And when you click on it, it says, I like Python. However, if you uncheck this, it still says, I like Python. So why don't we upgrade our display function? We'll check to see if the value stored within x is equal to 1, then we'll print, I like Python. Otherwise, we'll display, I don't like Python. So we'll check to see if the value in x is equal to 1. And it's not enough to say if x is equal to 1. Since we're storing our value as an object by using intvar, we need to retrieve whatever value is within here. So we can use x.get function. If x.get is equal to 1, we'll print I like Python. Else, we'll print a different message. Print, I don't like Python, and I don't know why you wouldn't like Python. All right, so let's give this a go then. So, I like Python, I don't like Python. I like Python, I don't like Python. All right, now let's take a look at our checkbox. It's somewhat dull, so let's spice things up a little bit. Let's decorate this checkbox. So let's begin by changing the font. So we can do this with the config function. Font equals, I will pick a font, maybe Arial, and a size, maybe 20. That's a little bit better. So this changes the font. Let's also change the font color. So we can do that with another config function. Otherwise, you can place this all within the same line, but it's going to get kind of cramped in all one line. So let's set the foreground color. We can set this to a name like blue. Otherwise, you can use a hexadecimal value. So blue is 0000FF. And now the font's blue. So this is the foreground color. Let's also change the background color. That is BG for background color. And I want this to be black, so that's all zeros. Okay, now pay attention to this. If we check the checkbox, this will flash to the original color, or if I hold this down. So we need to change the active foreground and active background if we want this to be consistent where it's not flashing every time you check this. So we're going to change the active foreground, and we're going to set this to the same color as our foreground. So these are both the same values. So this is active foreground. We're also going to change the active background. And we're also going to want this to be black as well. Active background. So this should no longer flash colors when we check this. It's all consistent. And now what we're going to be doing at this point is adding an image next to our check button. So I'm going to be adding this Python logo that I downloaded. And we're also going to be creating a second check button. And I'm going to add a Java logo to the second check button. So if you need some time, feel free to pause the video and download some images that you might want to use if you want to follow along. Otherwise, let's get started. So we're going to create a photo image. I'll just name this photo. Photo equals photo image. File equals either the file path or the file name. Since this is in the same folder as my Python file, I can just list the file name. So I'm going to use my file called python_logo.png. So I'm going to type that within file. And then we're going to set the image of our check button to equal this photo. So image equals whatever this name is, photo. Sets image to photo image. And let's try this. So this image replaced our text. If we want to keep the text, we can use compound. And we can set the image to the left, right, up, down, whatever. I'll have this image be on the left. And this should display the text. Yep, it does. Now let's add some padding around our text. So we can use pad X and pad Y. So pad X, I'll set this to 25. This should add some padding on the X axis. So that gives us a little bit of space. And pad Y, maybe 10. That's not too bad for spacing. Let's also set the width and the height. Width equals maybe 250 and height 50. Okay, that's not too shabby. Now let's create a second checkbox. Now why don't we create a second variable? We'll call this y, and this is also IntVar. And let's copy everything that we have for our first checkbox, paste this underneath, and we're going to replace the name of checkbox with a different name. So a shortcut is to select all of this, go to Edit, Find, Replace. We're going to replace checkbox with checkbox 2, and then click Replace All. And then we can close out of this. We're also going to make a few other changes. So text equals, let's say Java, variable equals Y, or whatever else you named your second variable. Let's see, we're going to use a different image. So we're going to use java_logo or whatever else you named your second image. And let's name this photo 2. So make sure to change that as well. And image equals photo 2. Now this should work. Okay, so we have two check buttons now, and we can check these independently. However, we can actually align these on the x-axis because they're centered right now, and it usually looks neat if you have these checkboxes aligned on the same axis. So we can do that by using anchor. So we'll do checkbox.config again. Anchor. And we can set this to a cardinal direction,
like W for west, E for east, N for north, S for south. There's a few other ones too, but let's anchor these on the west side of our window. So checkbox.config anchor equals W, and the same thing for checkbox two. So these are now anchored on the west side of our window. So they're kind of aligned now. That makes it look a little more neat and professional. So I'm just going to add a quick comment that this anchors widget to relative cardinal direction. Now let's change our display function now that we have two checkboxes, and we don't want this to say, I like Python, I don't like Python when we select Java. And now with our if statement, we're going to add something. If x.get is equal to 1 and y.get is equal to 0, we'll still display I like Python. Let's copy this and add an else if statement. Else if x.get is equal to 0 and y.get is equal to 1, I like Java. Let's add another else if. Else if x is equal to 1 and y is equal to 1, I like both Python and Java. Else will display, perhaps, I don't like either. Okay, let's try this. I like Python, I don't like either. I like Java, I don't like either. I like Python, I like both Python and Java. All right, everybody, so that's the basics of check buttons. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of check buttons in Python. Hey, you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in 3 easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.